During the lifetime of your application, you can expect the amount of allocated memory to change quite frequently. For example, needing to allocate a whole load of bitmaps for your social media stream, or plotting a new jogging path that takes your user past a trendy new donut shop. What's tricky, though, is seeing how these allocations can impact your performance. My name is Colt McAnlis, and with the help of a snazzy new tool in Android Studio, you can get a better sense of how your application is using memory, which can help you track down any related performance issues before your users start to notice. And these issues are now easier to solve with Android Studio's new Memory Monitor utility. This tool can give a quick visual overview of how your application is using memory over time. On the top left of the window, you'll see your currently connected device, and on the right, the selected application that you'd like to monitor. If you have multiple devices or apps active, this is where you'll select between them. The graph in the middle of the window is a stacked graph. That is, the amount of memory that your application is currently using is shown in dark blue, while the unallocated memory that's available to be used is shown in light blue right above it. Over time, this graph will continue to update, showing you changes in your memory usage. Now, in a world where your app isn't doing much of anything, you should see a flat graph just like this one. From a performance perspective, this is actually an ideal scenario. See, as your app allocates and frees memory, you'll see the allocated amount fluctuate in your graph at the same time. Anytime your allocated memory drops by a significant amount, that's a signal that a garbage collection event has occurred. Now, these GC events aren't generally a noticeable performance problem. However, a lot of them occurring over and over and over again in a short period of time can actually lead to performance issues. The more time you're spending doing GCs, the less time you'll have to do other stuff like rendering or streaming audio. To enable the Memory Monitor, start Android Studio, connect a physical device, and run your app. Then go back and select Memory Monitor from the Tools menu. Once the monitor is running, a new tab at the bottom of your screen will show up with all the relevant information. While Memory Monitor will help you know the general health and performance of your system, it doesn't help you track down any problems related to that. For that, you actually need something more powerful, like the Memory Heap tool, which will allow you to find out where in your code objects are being created but not released, created and not used, or created new when you could have been reusing them from existing objects. While Java's memory managed environment makes it easy for you to work with memory, it takes a lot of effort to ensure that those processes keep your app running at top speed, which is why you need to check out the rest of the Android Performance Patterns content for other great tips and tricks on efficient memory usage. And don't forget to join our Google Plus community as well for in the trenches advice from other developers. So keep calm, profile your code, and always remember, perf matters.